will solve HC verma problem 73, chapter 29, and we will solve only the part C of the problem, because if you are able to solve part 3, the other part A and B are relatively easy. So I am taking the slightly relatively difficult one. Difficulty is always relative. There is no such thing as difficulty. Anyway, in the dipole, the basic things which we should know is there are two equal and opposite charges. They are separated by some distance, say A, or we can take it as twice L or whatever. There is a separation which is quite small as compared to this distance, which is R, from the center of the dipole. This separation is quite small, means twice L is very, very less than R. This is one thing. And for a dipole, you have one is E theta. If you draw a line joining the center of the dipole and perpendicular to the line in this direction, means where there is minus Q, towards that side is E theta, and along the R is ER. These are two vectors, and value of ER is twice P cos theta upon 4 pi E0 R cube, and value of E theta is equal to P sin theta upon 4 pi E0 R cube. The derivation you can check. These two formulas you should always remember. This angle is theta between the line joining the dipole and the radius vector joining the center of the dipole. Now the case, this was just the basic, the case which is given to us is like this. There is a point P. This is point P. There is a positive charge here, and then there are also charges here, minus Q and plus Q. So just for the time being, imagine there is no charge here. So you have a dipole. Don't place this charge here, it is creating confusion. Just keep it in your memory separately. We will place it smartly at a later stage. Forget it. This is a dipole now. This is the angle theta, which is 90 degree. Cos 90 is 0, so ER will be 0. Sin 90 is 1, so you have E theta, which is in this direction. So E theta is equal to P, is the dipole moment here. Don't confuse with this point. Let this point be A. P upon 4 pi E0. This distance is given as D in the book. So take as D cube. This is the value of E theta. Now the dipole problem is solved. Now place this charge here. A charges effect you can always superimpose. You can ignore this. You place this charge here. Now what is the electric field due to this charge? Very simple. The electric field due to this charge will be in this direction, and it will be Q upon 4 pi E0 d square. So the resultant electric field would be, this is E theta and this is E. Resultant will be somewhere in between them, not exactly in between them, and E resultant would be equal to, E resultant would be equal to E square plus E theta square under root. Just place the values and you will get 1 upon 4 pi E0 d square, you take separate. Now this is, because square and root we have taken out, so no impact on that. So you have P upon d whole square, P upon d whole square plus Q square. This d square we have taken out, it is like this. So it becomes P square plus QD whole square under root upon d square, and we do square root, it will be d. D will come out, so it will be 1 upon 4 pi e 0 d cube is the resultant electric field in this case. So in such problems, just do the superimposition method and one should then be able